Welcome back to part 8 of the Revell Iveco build. This is the final part. We've got all the bits laid out just off out of camera shot. I think you can see them now. Got some up there and just some over there. And basically these are the finishing touches, front bumper, footsteps, mirrors, and some side panels that go onto the actual lorry. So I'm going to try and see if we can bear with me for a minute. There we go. Let's see. So we've got the cab sitting on the chassis. I've done the magnetic front so it clips into place, because I think it's a shame for not adding the engine detail. So right, so let's put you back that way and let's get this front bumper built up. Also, as you can see, I've done all the lights and all that. So we need to turn that over. So, just give it another little bit just on the top. And that gives it its, I assume it's like another grill, to be honest. Let's come down a little bit more. Right, we've got to put some treads, and I think that's it for the front bumper. So let's cut these off. Sorry that this series is really dragged out, but obviously I have been somewhat ill. Obviously the big one sits on the top. And let's hit a new one on the bottom as well. Now these are not sided by the looks of it. Goes into there. And you see this little one. Sorry for the camera angle. see that one is now in. So that is literally the front bumper done. Well, it's not completely done. We've still got some bits that we've got to put on now. Doesn't seem to want to sit in there for some reason, but it's in. Right, now we need the number plate, which like so. Plate is in. That was done. No, it's just out of the view of the camera. Oh, but it's in. Quite a tricky bit, but there you go. Right, that's all on. Perfect. So now, move them to one side. We've got these bits. If I can just lift you up just ever so slightly, that'd be perfect. So this one is 6s, and once again, bam. Now see, these just sit in here like so. So the camera view, very sorry. Drop down. And this one. So one. Steps in as well. Right, now we have to stick these. into there. So a bit of glue again. Excuse me. Like so, and that one, like so, then that is that bit done for the moment. So we can just leave that just to sit over there. It's saying that we need to put it on, so let's bring you down. Let's see, we've got these pieces here, and they sit in to there. So I should move the line there. Just gonna cut it there a minute, just so I can manoeuvre all the camera. Just obviously got the front cap off. Doesn't seem to want to tip because it's this bumper, and I can't fathom out why. Because technically it should, but it is what it is. So, right, next one is the home. It sits up in there. I mean, you just think to yourself, you're just about done with it. I'm literally done with it now. It's just been a constant battle. Quite easy, so it has burnt me up because it is full on. This has been a proper full on kit, but we're on the home stretch now, and it will be finished in this video. Just getting all my other pieces out that's needed. Right. So obviously we've done all this bit out there, which obviously that shot off, so I've just got to put these side pieces on. Which it's just another thing. I mean, would I build another lorry kit again? Probably. Would I do it soon? Probably not. But it's a learning curve. And it's by far the most decals kit. I've done. Don't get me wrong, I've enjoyed doing it, but enough's enough now. Right. Obviously, we've got tin advisors to go on over there, but that is not yet. As with most things, just tend to try and hold it, because obviously that has to go in a specific way. That's tinted. Which we put that on. I mean, I have got other lorry kits. It's just now side mirrors. See, this is the thing with it, it's always battling you. Right, let me come back because I'm gonna have to take that on. Somewhat got it held in place. Thank God for masking tape. Right, final steps now. Right, let's turn it round. We've got a mirror to go in here, which is this one. For this side, we need 63 and 60. I know I'm doing quite a lot of this out of the camera shot, I'm ever so sorry. Sorry if I've gone quiet. just... just not feeling it anymore now. Just gets to the point where you just want it done. So I'm saying it's not really telling you which bit's the bottom and which bit's the top. They're just basically stating I'm not gonna cut anything out. Right, number 60 was this. So 60 goes up the top. Don't get me wrong, this ain't perfect. In 63, which is the big piece. Goes to the bottom. Just gonna literally let them sit up before we even attempt technically. She's a bit gray. Same on the other side. Didn't you work? And that's the thing. That makes sense. That is final piece. Thank God. It has come a long way. But what I'm gonna do, just let that set up, take all the masking tape off, then we'll get it coming for a close up. And there we have it. Is it perfect? Far from it. Have I enjoyed the build? Yeah, at times. You know, it was a challenging build. I mean, I've got fingerprints everywhere, but yeah, it's there. I mean, if you come to the front, it comes off, some magnets, goes back on. I'm not sure if this is actually meant to move, but it seems to get stuck. And it's as far as I can get it to go. But, I mean, that's the end. This is the Revell 1/24 scale Iveco Stratus. It's been numerous Tamiya X and X paints, XF paints, and LP paints. Mr. Hobby Metal Cutter 213. What else? It was painted in Zero Paints. Zero Paints. Deep purplish blue metallic, which is a Yamaha colour, which is as close to the box cut as I could get it. What else? It is cleared with 2K multi-mix clear, which is a car clear. It's cheaper. I think you could probably pick a litre up with Hardener about 20-25 pounds as of recording this, but obviously I have 5 litres, so because obviously I do other bits and bobs in my spare time. But now, as you can see, it is I've enjoyed it. It's been tough, but and I hope you're right. I had a little bit of reaction on certain places where the decals are, but I'm putting that down to because it was an old kit that I bought off of eBay many years ago. So, but would I build another lorry kit? Yeah, I would, but just not yet. But as you can see, it doesn't look too bad. That's my first ever lorry kit. Yeah, I've still got a couple of touch-ups like up there to do and down here, but that's nothing. That's bits and bobs I can do, so off camera. But that is it. I will do, these will be scheduled to for uploads on a Friday. So then after them, I'll do an update video of what's been going on, why I've not done regular uploading for a little while, and then we will get my other build going. So, but yeah, and obviously I'll give you a little update as well. So thanks for watching. If you like what you see, hit the subscribe button, like and share, and I'll see you very soon on the next one. Bye for now.